C4 and Bryan Nehman.
Listen wherever you are.
FM 97.9 HD2, WBAL.com, and the WBAL radio app.
Today, we are announcing that Commissioner Harrison will be departing his role.
Departing his role as Baltimore City Police Commissioner. That was the announcement 2 weeks ago today. And departing, Bryan Nehman, an audience, I picked up kind of on that to say, okay, does that mean he's fired, he's resigning? Well, that question is still lingering around today with some other issues they want to talk about with Baltimore City Councilman Eric Costello. He's the chairman of the Ways and Means Committee that just finished the budget of the city of Baltimore recently, but he's also on the Public Safety Committee, which had a meeting yesterday. Good morning, Councilman.
Hey, Councilman.
Hey, thanks for having me, guys.
Look, this question was asked by our own Phil Yakubuski yesterday here at WBAL to two of your colleagues, Councilwoman Odette Ramos, as well, Councilman, as Councilman Mark Conway, the chairman of Public Safety Committee, about the status of Michael Harrison. If you could go ahead, Kevin.
Where is that going at this point? Is he going to be paid out to the end?
I don't know.
Are you satisfied with that answer or no?
I don't know. I haven't been bought into the conversations with the commissioner. It's all been a personnel matter for which I have not been brought into.
Should he be paid till the end of his contract? Or
it depends on the situation, you know, depending on what his contract said, right? If he was terminated, then he gets a severance. If it was a resignation, it's something else. So, you know, it depends on the terms of the contract.
Nobody seems to know the answers to those questions, though, right?
That's right.
Okay, maybe you do, Councilman. What do you know of the status of this situation?
Well, I have the contract in front of me. There's four options for separation from employment. One is termination by the city for just cause. One is termination by the city without cause. One is termination if appointment is not confirmed. That's if he was never confirmed by the city council. So that's a moot point. And then the fourth is resignation by the executive. I didn't hear that, you know, he was terminated with cause at all during any of these conversations. To me, it sounded like, you know, this was an amicable separation.
Right.
So I can only assume that it's termination by the city, you know, without cause, or resignation by the executive. If it's resignation by the executive, the contract is pretty clear. He must give at least 90 days written notice. In the event of a resignation, executive shall not be entitled to severance pay, as detailed in Section 6B, but shall receive accrued salary for services performed up until the effective date of his resignation, and the payout of any leave required by his agreement and applicable city policies. So this is a contract that had to go before the Board of Estimates. I think this was approved back in March of 2019. So, January 31st of 2019. So question is he still working for the city and what is he doing?
Right. Well, that's where I was going to go. I mean, do we know if he is actually working at all? Is he an advisor? Is he some kind of consultant at all? I mean, is he doing any type of work right now for the city of Baltimore?
I'm unclear on that, but I'd like an answer to that. So I'll be seeking an answer on that today.
Does the mayor have to? I mean, is there anything legally speaking that he needs to disclose to the board or to the city council on that at all? Legally speaking,
there's nothing in the law or in code or in the contract that requires the mayor to notify the city council around anything related to this. This is the first that I've really talked with anyone about this, so I couldn't tell you, you know, what reasons the mayor or the law department may have. I've heard that the mayor has said it's a personnel matter. This is how personnel matters are usually treated in city government and, frankly, in local and state governments across the country. So that being said, I still would like to know that, you know, whether or not he is continuing to work for the city, like to know when he resigned. This is a $300,000+ salary.
Right.
A lot of taxpayer dollars.
And Councilman Costello, I want to be very clear, and Bryan, that I personally like Michael Harrison. I think for the most part, he did a really good job as police commissioner, but it has nothing to do, as a city resident as I am, as a taxpayer, with my wanting to know the difference between why he's leaving so that either we're paying severance or not paying. This is an issue of finances, Councilman, not of whether or not we're being nosy or anything.
Yeah, I mean, I think people have a right to know whether or not he's working and he's still getting paid. That's it. It's very clear from the press conference two Thursdays ago that it was an amicable separation.
Right.
You know, the mayor and the commissioner both said as much. I have no reason to not take either of them at their word on that. So, you know, is he working or is he not? Is he getting paid or is he not? That's it. It doesn't have to be any more complicated than that.
Why do you think?
That's a reasonable question to ask.
Why?
I couldn't speculate as to why. I just couldn't tell you. But again, oftentimes in local and state government, this is how, you know, matters of personnel are handled.
Yeah. So, I mean, let me just play devil's advocate on that. Like, hey, it's no big deal. I mean, it's like he wanted out. The mayor's ready for him to move on. They're trying to work out an agreement. They make an arrangement. Maybe he's paid until the end of his contract, or maybe he's paid to the end of this year. Does it really make that much of a difference, just knowing that he's just not the police commissioner anymore?
I think it makes a difference. I mean, you know, again, if they separated on amicable terms, it's the mayor's prerogative to keep him employed with the city. And people have a right to know if he's working or not. If he's working, he deserves to get paid. You know, if he's not working, per the terms of the contract I just read you, he, you know, should not be getting paid. Again, the real question that you should be asking is, what is the date that he officially resigned?
Mm-hmm.
Was that the date of the press conference? Was it before? Has it happened yet? That's the real question you should be asking, because the date that he resigned is what is going to legally guide how long he should be getting paid for.
Well, that's the question, Councilman, that I was asking. Was there a 90-day-ago written notification of resignation, as you appropriately read into the contract? And this is just about contractual stuff. Once again, this isn't like or dislike. If there wasn't a 90-day written notice, then what are we talking about?
Yeah, and again, if he had submitted a resignation 2 weeks ago and came to an agreement with the mayor to, you know, continue his employment with the city in some different capacity. You know, the mayor is, the way our government is structured, the mayor is entitled to do that. And all that would be perfectly valid and legal. But again, it's unclear until you know the date of the resignation. Yeah.
But is it?
The rest of it is all speculation, unfortunately.
But it's kind of speculation that we're saying that he resigned. I mean, isn't it more likely that he didn't resign? Isn't it more likely that they just had an agreement, maybe there was a separate contract written on a severance, or perhaps he's just still under contract until the end of the year, just they took it away of his title being police commissioner?
I honestly couldn't say. I would be speculating.
Yeah.
I, you know, again, I think the $64,000 question here, or in this case rather, is one quarter of $300,000. So $75,000 question here is, you know, what date did he resign? The answer to that question guides the rest of the conversation moving forward. But
that assumes that he did resign. But that's what I'm saying. I think it's a real possibility that he never resigned. Do you think that's a possibility at all?
I would be speculating. Couldn't tell you. You know, but I think again, the mayor and the police commissioner, or the mayor and the former commissioner, were pretty clear in their press conference that, you know, there was going to be a separation. One would assume that, you know, that means that there's a resignation in place if it was amicable.
Well, Baltimore City Councilman Eric Costello is on board with us. You said you're going to be asking questions later on today about this. In what capacity will that occur?
In what capacity?
Like, are you have a meeting? Is there a committee meeting? Or, you know,
I plan to look into this today. This issue's been, you know, bubbling up for the past couple of days. And, you know, as soon as I get out of meetings early this afternoon, I'm going to be looking into it. So probably start with some phone calls and emails and go from there.
And the reason I'm asking that, Bryan, real quick, is because we do have another commissioner coming in, Richard Worley, and I know they all, you know, have their own individual contracts, but wouldn't this be an issue with the next commissioner to have just some clarity on how these things are kind of actually done?
I couldn't tell you each.
Right.
Worley is the sixth commissioner I've had the opportunity to serve with. Each time a new commissioner has come in, there's a set of negotiations that occur. Those are not public.
Right.
An agreement is reached, and then the final contract is submitted to the Board of Estimates for the board's approval. At that time, the terms that have been successfully negotiated are made public, as are, you know, other documents associated with items on the Board of Estimates docket. So presumably that would happen in the instance of Acting Commissioner Worley, as, you know, his terms of his employment are, I'm sure, currently being negotiated.
Well, finally, Councilman Costello, we always appreciate the time when you can be with us. There are questions being raised now about who actually is operating Safe Streets. Apparently, that the mayor had said that there were two entities that were operating the 10 Safe Streets. And according to reports now, the Park Heights Safe Streets entity is still being operated by a third entity. Is any of that, like, what is told to you, members of the Public Safety Committee and the council, about who's operating this?
I haven't had any direct communication from the administration or from Monsey regarding the Park Heights Safe Street site.
Okay.
So I couldn't tell you. This is the first I'm hearing that.
Well, hopefully you guys, I'm going to talk to Councilman Conway. We'll look in just who's running, like who's the oversight of this. We appreciate your time, Councilman.
Thanks as always.
Thanks a lot, Bryan. Thanks, yeah. Before.
All right, I appreciate it. He doesn't know anything either.
I know.
That's three council people now.
It seems to me that he didn't resign. That, I mean, if he resigned, they would say that the letter is there.
Because if he had said the word resign, you would have had to have a 90-day notice.
Yeah.
What I'm saying. There's certain contractual reasons they didn't use fire or resign. They didn't use that language.
I mean, let's think about it. Just walk through this. Is it Harrison, the mayor's like, hey, dude, are you going to Washington? What are we going to do here? And the mayor's like, dude. And the commissioner's like, hey, are you going to extend my contract? I want to extend my contract. And he says, well, I'm not going to extend it. All right. Well, then I'm not resigning. So what are we going to do? Let's work something out. And
then we get the press conference.
Right. And then he's gone, but he's still being paid. And my guess is he's going to be paid through the end of his contract.
I don't have a problem with him being paid. I have a problem with us not knowing what capacity all this is happening in. What is the role and what's happening
right.
from a taxpayer standpoint?